Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. We're just getting this boat build done. Of course, the boat's never done, right? But for those who are going to ask, I know. Black Tip Jet Sports on Amazon for the floor covering. Absolutely love the stuff. We went with a little homemade manufactured trolling motor mount here. LED driving lights, those are 100 watts a piece. And then as far as floodlights go, these are ones in the front are 150 watt Vogrums. And then on the sides, we've got 50s. I've got two more back there in the back on either side. So lighting wise, we've got 1050s and 650s. That gives us 1500 watts, and I'm running that all 120 volt AC off of my Predator 2000 generator, which has been a pretty good buy, $450 versus $900 for that other red motor. Just two plugs, port starboard, worked out pretty good. But I wanted to show you guys the new sound system. Wanted to do something, but I didn't want to break the bank. Everybody says stay away from sound bars, so this is what we went with. Now, this is the Pyle Marine amplifier. It is a two-channel Bluetooth amplifier. Comes with white or black. Total output's 400 watts, guys, and this thing is tiny. Just to keep a good signal, instead of mounting it completely in the console and being wrapped by aluminum on all three sides, or four sides, I went ahead and mounted it right there. Now, you see how big my hand is? See how big it is? Pretty simple. Positive wire, negative wire, and a memory wire. You just put your switch on that power wire, and then it's already fused. It does have a 3.5 millimeter jack that you can mount in the console, and then it also has a switch, but I'm not real fond of it because it's a power switch for the amplifier, but in off position all the way down, it's just volume down. The amplifier is still on. So what I did was I designated a switch on my panel. As you can see, it's on because we've already got our Amazon Prime synced up to our phone. But just did a 10 amp fuse on my switch. That way I keep my console clean, okay? There's no need for me to run that 3.5 millimeter jack. There's no need for me to run, you know, I don't need a head unit. I don't need pretty much anything. Now, speaker-wise, we wanted something that would bump, but we also wanted to be as economical as possible. So I found some 8-inch wakeboard speakers and just took the back part of the bracket off and went ahead and mounted them right underneath here. It's gonna work out pretty dang good. Go ahead, babe. Let's have some Amazon music there. This system gets pretty good and loud. Now, unfortunately, for the monetization of this video and YouTube copyright laws, I'm not gonna play a whole lot of music, but you'll just have to take my word for it. For a 50 amp, or a $50 amp, and $100 set of speakers, I got $158 in this sound system, and you know, about an hour and a half of wiring and mounting it, and most of that was making that bracket back there to hang it, so. I hope you guys liked the video. I will put a link in the description to this Pyle amplifier. As of now, I highly recommend it. It's compact, economical, easy to install, and hey, perfect for us bow fishing guys. As always guys, stay safe while you're on the water. Don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell if you haven't. And check out my new project, The Outdoor Mentors. Totally new channel, and I need you guys as subscribers to get on over there because I can't monetize any videos until I reach 1,000 subs. So go ahead over there and ring that bell as well, and I'll see you guys on the water. Thanks for joining me.